Hello friends, welcome to the session. We are dealing with the industrial drives. Today we will be discussing about stepper motor drives. In present days, the applications of stepper motors have increased because of their many advantages, such as the cost of stepper motor drives is very less, the size is also compact, and you can control it in a very simple with a very simple circuit. At present, switched reluctance motor drives are at a developmental stage and they have several applications. Their advantages include the ruggedness, the cost, the high torque to inertia ratio, and simple control. Now we'll just look at what exactly a stepper motor is. A stepper motor can be considered as a digital electromechanical device in that every step command pulse, that is nothing but an electrical input pulse, it will be resulting in movement of the shaft in discrete angles. We call it as a step angle of the motor. When a given number of pulses are applied to the motor, the shaft will be turned through a known angle. That is, motor can be used to control position by keeping the count of the number of command pulses. Also, we can say that the average motor speed is proportional to rate at which the pulses are delivered. We can note here that at low command pulse rate, rotor moves in stepwise, but when the pulse rate it is high, sufficiently high, that time it moves smoothly. The reason behind it will be it is inertia and it moves smoothly as in case of DC motors. It can be used for speed control as the motor speed is proportional to the rate of pulses. Hence, motor is ideally suited for open loop position and speed control. I can say the control is very simple as neither a position nor a speed sensor and also not a feedback loop are required for stepper motor to make the output response to follow the input. And also we can note here that as the commands are in pulses, motor is compatible to digital systems also. Few applications of the stepper motors include printers, tape drives, disk circuits, machine tools, process control, recorders, robotics, in textile industry, and in integrated circuit fabrication. These are used. Next, moving to the classification of stepper motors, these are divided as variable reluctance, permanent magnet, and hybrid types of motors. In that, we'll start with the first one, that is variable reluctance stepper motor. These can be of either single stack or multi-stack type. So now we'll be discussing about single stack variable reluctance motor. This variable reluctance stepper motor has a salient pole, stator and rotor, while as the rotor has no windings and stator has concentrated coils which are placed over the stator poles. When the stator phases are excited using a DC source through semiconductor switches. The air gap field, it will steps around around, and rotor follows the axis of air gap field. This is because of reluctance torque developed by the tendency of magnetic circuit, and it occupies the position of minimum reluctance. The figure shows a four phase 4x2 pole. Why I am calling this as 4x2 pole is the four poles in stator and two in rotor. So four in stator and two in rotor, I call it as 4/2 rotors. This figure shows a four phase 4/2 pole single stack variable reluctance stepper motor. Now the four phases are marked as A, B, C and D, and those are connected to the DC source through semiconductor switches, namely SA, SB, SC and SD respectively. Now these phases are excited in the sequence of A, B, C, D, again back to A, B and so on, the cycle repeats. Now we'll just look at the how exactly it operates. Say A is excited, then the reluctance torque causes rotor to turn. The rotor is stable in this position and cannot move until phase A is de-energized. And next, when phase B is excited and A is disconnected, rotor turns through 90 degrees in a clockwise direction. It is rotating just to align with the resultant air gap field, which now lies along with the phase B. That is, as the phases are excited in the sequence A, B, C, D, A and so on, rotor turns with a step of 90 degree each time in clockwise direction. Now the direction, reverse the direction. Now the rotation direction can be reversed just by reversing the sequence of switching the phases. That is, first A, D, C, B, A, D and so on. The direction of the rotation only depends on the sequence in which phases are switched, and it is independent of direction of currents through the phases. Now, as there are only four phases, the step angle is 90 degree. We can reduce it to 45 degree by exciting the phases in the sequence, like A and B together, then B and C together, then C and D together, then D and A together, then A and so on. Like this, the 360 degree is partitioned into 8 parts. Then the phase angle will be 45 degree. With each excitation, the motor will be rotating for an angle of 45 degree. Thank you.